Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today I'm going to be testing an IC693MDL340. This is a 9030 discrete output module. It's 120 volts AC, and there are 16 points total, 8A and 8B channels. So in order to do this test, I have a couple fixtures here, some things that are already set up. According to the door card, if you look at this insert in the wiring diagram, terminal number 9 and terminal number 19 have a hot lead on both of them. So you can see that I've got this jumpered from 9 to 19 with a hot lead coming from a 120 volt AC power cord that I'll be plugging in for this test. The neutral lead from the 120 volt AC is going to another cord, which is attached to a drop light. So the neutral lead from the drop light and the neutral lead from the 120 volt AC are tied together right here. The hot lead from the drop light, this is the black wire, the hot lead, is going to a probe. So what I'm going to do is, as I turn each channel on, all the 16 channels, I'm going to touch this probe to all those corresponding channels in order to get the light to turn on. If the light turns on, it means that the switch or the output is working properly. If it doesn't turn on when it's supposed to be on, then it's not working properly. That's the whole test. The other thing we want to do, of course, is shut all the outputs off and make sure that they stay off and they're not stuck in the on position, giving us a false belief that it's in good working condition. All right, so the rest of the equipment that I have here in front of you is an IC693CHS397 5-slot rack. It's being powered by an IC693PWR330 power supply, and the processor I'm using is an IC693CPU374+. So what I'm going to do is start a new fresh file in Proficy Machine Edition. Something completely blank. Once I've opened up a file that's set for 9030 platform, 9030 PLC platform, I'm going to go to my navigator bar. I'm going to expand my main rack, and I'm going to choose the 5-slot rack, the CHS397, PWR330 power supply, CPU374+, or rather just CPU374. Processor, and in slot number 2, the IC693MDL340 that we're going to be testing, and nothing else. This is just a test for the module on its own. And the first thing I want to do is I'm going to double click on slot number 2, or you can right click and configuration. What I'm looking for is, there's no real configuration for this module, but I want to know where my reference address is so that when I toggle the bits from a 0 to a 1 in my output table, I know where to start. So this is a brand new fresh file. The one that I have is percent Q, or percent output, 00001. So I'll be starting by toggling the first bit and go all the way through 16. Okay, now that the physical configuration that you see here is also set up in Proficy Machine Edition, I'm going to go to target at the top of the screen, and to online commands about halfway down, and I'm going to select clear. I should back up a moment. The first thing that I do actually is click the lightning bolt icon, and this will toggle me to online mode. Once that's online, I'm going to select the green handprint, which is to put me in program mode, and then go to target, online commands, clear. Once the online commands window pops up, I want to go to clear. And what I want to do here is just the controller fault table and IO fault table, the bottom two selections only. There's no need to erase all memory or anything like that. Logic, initial values, force values, there's no reason to do any of that. So just any inherent faults, because the processor was performing another task before this. And then select OK. We'll clear those two things. And then I'm going to hit the download and run button, which is the download information, and play button in one. That's going to tell you that the build is currently in progress. This takes a minute. First thing it's going to ask you is, what exactly do you want to download to the controller from Proficy? Just hardware configuration and motion and logic. That's the top two selections. So I'm going to click on both of those. I don't want to write anything to permanent flash memory or anywhere else, just to those. I'm going to select OK. The build will continue. And once it's done, the last thing it's going to ask you is if you want to enable the outputs or put the processor into run mode. Okay. So once that's done, and it is, we're going to enable the outputs. We have a green light here. It shows the processor is in run mode. And also on Proficy Machine Edition, you can see on the bottom portion of your screen, tells you the status of where your controller is. It should say run enabled, logic equal, configuration equal. So now that we have an up and working system, I'm going to go down to, in my navigator bar once again, my default tables, go to output or percent Q, and double click on that, and the output table will pop open. And I'm going to start on the top right hand corner. For my configuration, that's where my module is. It's at address 0001. And I'm going to start turning on all these bits. So I'm turning the zeros to ones. As you can see on the module in front of me, the MDL340, all of my A and B channels are coming on. Okay, so now they're all on. I have, for user reference, I have the 1 through 8 for both channels on, and that tells me that it's on. It doesn't necessarily mean that it's a working channel, so I still have to test it to make sure. I'm going to plug in my hot lead to power up the outputs, and I'm going to touch the probe to each channel. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, those are all working, my B channels. 1 through 8. Now, as I said before, I'm going to go through and I'm going to toggle all those ones to zeros in my output table. And I'm going to back off all these outputs so you can see all the lights are going out, suggesting that the output is off. Again, it doesn't necessarily mean that the output really is off, but we're going to check it anyway. Now, always test your test equipment. I do that even though I know I just used this light bulb. I kind of tap it to the light, you know, make sure nobody unplugged it, make sure that the bulb didn't burn out or something happened. So now I know it's a working fixture once again. And I'm going to test all my outputs. That should be in the off position. B channels. Okay. So that's a perfect working unit. Just to recap, you know, if there's a problem with the unit, you'll see a couple possible different things. Either you'll go to turn the outputs on and you will not get any of the LEDs coming on that indicate that the channels A1 through 8, B1 through 8 are on. So that might be a problem. The other problem could obviously be that the channel appears to come on, you get the LED light coming on, and you go to probe it the way I just have, and you don't get a light that comes on. So it's kind of a false reading. And then the other thing, of course, is when you go and shut all of the outputs off, you may have one or two or several that are still on. So any of those three things is the typical problems that we see with an MDL340 that's troubled. So if you do have a problem with it, this is something that we do repair. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same-day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.